Hello friends, welcome to our channel tutel.com. So today we are going to discuss about Euclid's division lemma and algorithm. Let's start. So you're already aware of the difference between lemma and algorithm. So what is this Euclid's division lemma? So we have two positive integers a and b. So there exists some unique integers q and r which will satisfy the relation a is equal to bq plus r. Where this r is greater than or equal to 0 but less than b, it should all be equal to b. So this equation is similar to dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder, which you were already studying in your previous classes. Next is Euclid's division algorithm. So we'll apply Euclid's division lemma to Euclid's division algorithm to find the HCF of two positive integers a and b. So how you're going to write HCF of two positive integers a and b? It is written as HCF within the brackets a comma b. So you will apply Euclid's division lemma to a and b till the step you get remainder 0. Fine. So let's understand more about Euclid's division algorithm by this example. So in this question, we want to find HCF of 960 and 432. First of all, you need to decide which number is greater. So out of 960 and 432, 960 is greater than 432. So we'll apply long division method. So 432 into 2 will give you 864. The concept is to find the number which is 960 or a number which is less than 960. So remainder is 96 here. Since remainder is not equal to 0, you will treat this remainder as your divisor, and your divisor will be treated as your new dividend. So 96 into 4 will give you 384, remainder will give you 48. Now again, remainder is not 0. So 48 into 2 will give you 96. At this stage, remainder becomes 0. So the last divisor will be your HCF. So HCF for 960 and 432 is 48. So if this question comes in your exam and you just show the long division, you may not get marks. So we need to write this question in the form of steps. Fine. So let's see how you're going to write the steps. So since here you will start, since 960 is greater than 432, you'll use the same concept. You'll write the steps as it is, fine. So you'll write, since 960 is greater than 432, we'll apply division lemma to 960 and 432. We'll write the equation in the form of dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. So let's see. 960 is equal to 432 into 2 plus 96, fine. So here you'll write remainder is 96, which is not 0. So we'll apply division lemma to 432 and 96. Again, we'll get 432 is equal to 96 into 4 plus 48. Again, remainder is not 0. So it is 96 is equal to 48 into 2 plus 0. Now the remainder becomes 0. We'll stop a procedure here. At this stage, divisor is 48. So HCF of 960 and 432 is 48. So if this question comes for supposedly 3 marks, so you will get 1-2 mark for all these steps. Fine, since here we are just dealing with 3 steps, and 1 mark for the final answer, which is 48. Let's see the second question. So this question says, if HCF of 210 and 55 is expressed in the form of 210m plus 55n, find the values of m and n. So this question is basically divided into two parts. First is to find the HCF, and second one is to find values of m and n. So we'll divide this question into two parts, and then just we'll start. Okay, so first part is to find HCF. Let's see. Obviously, we'll find HCF using Euclid's division algorithm. Writing steps is mandatory. Okay, so how are you going to start? So 210 is equal to 55 into 3 plus 45. This is your equation number 1. Then 55 is equal to 45 into 1 plus 10, equation number 2, because here remainder is not 0. So you will treat your remainder as your divisor, and your divisor will be treated as your new dividend. So 45 is equal to 10 into 4 plus 5, and 10 is equal to 5 into 2 plus 0. Now here remainder is 0. So HCF of 210 and 55 will be the last divisor. Fine. So HCF is 5. This was the first part of the question, which will give you 1.5 mark if this question comes for 3 marks. And this question is important from CBSE point of view. This year also, in 2020, CBSE has given this question for 3 marks. Okay, so the second part of the question says HCF is written in the form of 210 m plus 55 n. So we can say HCF is equal to 210 m plus 55 n. So for such type of questions, what you have to do is you always have to start from the second last equation, as in your last equation will give you remainder as zero. So you will start from the second last equation where remainder is not zero, and you will keep on substituting the value of remainder from each equation till we reach the first equation. So from each equation, basically the concept is we will find the value of remainder from each equation. We'll go on substituting the values till we reach the equation number one. And value of what? Value of remainder. Let's see how. So this is your equation number four, where remainder is zero. Second last equation is equation number three. Here remainder is five. So value of remainder, which is 5, is you have to take 10 into 4 to other side. You will not going to solve any part. I mean, you will not find the value. You just have to substitute. Fine. So you will take 10 into 4 to other side. So what you will get? 5 is equal to 45 minus 10 into 4. This will be your equation number 5. Now you have to look to equation number 2. In equation number 2, your remainder is 10. So value of this 10 will be 55 minus 45 into 1. We're going to substitute value of 10 in equation number 5, which is 55 minus 45 into 1. So 5 as it is, 45 minus, so what you will get in place of 10, you can write 55 minus 45 into 1 into 4 as it is. You're going to make use of brackets. Making use of bracket is very important. Fine. So you're just going to open the bracket. So we have, okay, how many times we're having 45 here? Let me just turn it to the pen mode. Okay, this is for one time and 1 into 4, 5 times. So we'll write 45 into 5, which is 5 times. So minus into plus will give you minus. So this minus sign, 55. Now this whole bracket is getting multiplied by 4. Fine. So you'll write 55 into 4. This will give you equation number 6. Now moving over to the first equation, here first equation, in first equation remainder is 45. So value of 45 will be, you have to take this 55 into 3 to other side. Fine. So what you will get? So 5 as it is, in place of 45 from equation number 1, we'll put 210 minus 55 into 3, then into 5 as it is, minus 55 into 4 as it is. Fine. So again, this whole bracket is getting multiplied by 5. So what you will get? 210 into 5 minus 3 into 5 will give you 15, minus 55 into 15, minus 55 into 4. So 210 into 5 as it is, we can take plus common, then 55, because we need to write our equation in the form of 210m. Okay, 210m plus 55n. So we need to write this plus sign outside. If it would have been minus 55n, then you would have taken negative sign outside the brackets. So this is 210 into 5 plus 55 into minus 19. So when you will compare this equation by the given equation, so this is equal to HCF. Fine. So you're going to write value of HCF here. HCF is 5. Fine. So 5 as it is, 210m. So when you compare these two equations, you get value of m as 5 and value of n as minus 19. So this will give you 1.5 mark. Fine. Don't leave such type of question. These questions are very important. Let's just move to the third question. Okay, third question says, show that one and only one out of n, n plus 2 and n plus 4 is divisible by 3, where n is any positive integer. So for this question, this number, n is any positive integer, will be treated as a, fine. You know the equation, again we'll use Euclid's division lemma. So we know a is equal to bq plus r, fine. So this n is any positive integer will be treated as your a. So in place of a, we'll write n. So whatever number here is given to you, divisible by 3, you will take this number as b, fine. You will take this number as b. If it would have been divisible by 2, then you will take this as b as 2. So n is equal to 3q plus r. So where r is 0, 1 and 2. So because why it is 0, 1 and 2? Because we know that r should be greater than or equal to 0, fine, and it should be less than b, and it is a whole number, so it is 0, 1, 2. So if r is 0, you know, now you are going to substitute value of r. So if r is 0, n is equal to 3q. If r is 1, n will be equal to 3q plus 1. And if r is 2, it is 3q plus 2. Now we have to prove that out of these three integers, 3q, 3q plus 1, 3q plus 2, in all the cases, only one is divisible by 3. Fine, let's take case 1. So in case 1, if n is equal to 3q, so we have n plus 2 here. So value of n plus 2, you will find values of n plus 2 and n plus 4 in all the three cases, because here we are dealing with three cases. One is 3q, second one is 3q plus 1, third one is 3q plus 2. So you will put values of, you'll find values of n plus 2, n plus 4 in all the three cases, and you will check whether they're divisible by 3 or not. So if n is equal to 3q, fine, this is divisible by 3. If a, let's check for n plus 2. We will put value of n. This is 3q plus 2. Again, supposingly q is 2 here. Fine, suppose. So if q is 2, n will be equal to 6. Obviously, it is divisible by 3. So for n plus 2, 3 into 2 will give you 6. 6 plus 2, but it is not divisible by 3. For n plus 4, it is 3q plus 4. Again, it is not divisible by 3. So in first case, out of n plus 2 and n plus 4, only n is divisible by 3. Fine. Let's check for the second case. In second case, n is equal to 3q plus 1. So n plus 2, it will be equal to 3q plus 1. In place of n, you will write 3q plus 1 plus 2 as it is. So you will get 3q plus 3. You can take 3 common, you will get q plus 1. This 3q plus 1 is not divisible by 3. Again, you can take q as 2. So if q is 2, 3 into 2 will give you 6. 6 plus 1 will give you 7. It is not divisible by 3. But 3 into something is divisible by 3. Again, n plus 4. In place of n, you will write 3q plus 1 plus 4 as it is. 3q plus 5. Again, not divisible by 3. So in this case, only 3 into q plus 1 is divisible by 3. That means n plus 2 is divisible by 3. Now let's check for third case. In case 3, n is equal to 3q plus 2. So n plus 2 will be equal to, in place of n, you will put the values 3q plus 2 plus 2 is equal to 3q plus 4. Again, it is not divisible by 3. Fine. And n is also not divisible by 3, right? So n plus 4, 3q plus 2 plus 4, you'll get 3q plus 6. You can take 3 common into something, q plus 2. Again, it is, this time this is divisible by 3. So in this case, only n plus 4 is divisible by 3. Hence, 1 and only 1 out of n plus 2 and n plus 4 is divisible by 3. So this type of question comes for 4 marks. So you can check many types of question on a website, like to check whether you have to show whether cube of any positive integer can be expressed in this form, likewise square of any positive integer, fine. So let's just quickly summarize what you have just learned. In real numbers, so we have two terms. One is lemma, second one is algorithm. This lemma is a proven statement which you can use to prove another statement. Fine. An algorithm is a process that is used to solve problems. Basically, algorithm will give you the steps, but lemma will not give you the steps. Lemma will just give you the proof to prove another statement. So we have Euclid's division lemma. Division lemma says A is equal to BQ plus R. And I told you this is similar to dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder, where this R is greater than or equal to 0 but less than B. For algorithm, we have Euclid's division algorithm. Let's just check the steps quickly. So you have to apply Euclid's division lemma to A and B. A is equal to BQ plus R, where R is greater than or equal to 0 and less than B. Now you have to check whether R is 0 or not. So you have to check, is R 0? If yes, then HCF of A and B will be B. If no, then you will apply division lemma to your divisor, which will become new dividend now, and your remainder, which will become divisor now. So you have to apply Euclid's division lemma to B and R. So you will continue this process till you get R as 0. So the last divisor will give you the HCF. Fine. So I hope this topic is clear to you. Please do like the video and don't forget to subscribe to our channel to make sure you don't miss any science and maths video. Visit www.tutel.com to watch educational videos, to try online tests, and to get the best quality study material and much more. Stay safe. Take care. Bye.